Dear students, good morning to all. My name is Dr. E. Purushottam. Today I am going to discuss about types of motion. In this types of motion, I will go to discuss the relation between translatory motion and rotatory motion. The translatory motion and rotatory motion principles we will discuss in our today's class. So these principles are very important because it is very useful in our next class. Dear students, you observe translatory motion and rotatory motion principles. But these principles very useful to next topic, that is torsional pendulum. So up to here, we learned about waves and oscillations. So simple harmonic motion. In that, our main syllabus is free oscillations. So types of oscillations, what is that types? What are the types? Number one, free oscillations, damped. Number two, damped oscillations. Number three, forced oscillations. So in free oscillations, we completed simple oscillator, that is equation of motion, that solution and characteristics of simple oscillator. So after that, our topic, torsional pendulum. So before this topic, torsional pendulum, we just observe types of motion. It is not, we will not ask in our examination point of view, but this is the bridge course topic. So types of motions, three types: translational motion, rotational motion, and rolling motion. You have studied in your intermediate 8th chapter, that is rotational motion. So what is a translational motion? A body moves along a straight line without any rotation. For example, fan. The motion of a car on the road, not fan. Fan is the rotational motion. So translational motion, a body moves along a straight line without any rotation. So motion of a car on the road, not motion of a wheel, that is the car you observe here. That is translational motion. Rotational motion, a body moves around a fixed axis. So car wheel or rotating fan, rotating wheel, etc. Rolling motion, a motion that combines translational motion and also rotational motion of the body or object with respect to a surface. This is the bike wheel also. So bike wheel, only rotating wheel. So this is rolling motion. What are the main differences between translational motion and rotational motion? So translational motion, just position or displacement, it is represented by X. But angular position, that is rotational motion, it is represented by theta. Theta, that is angular position. So it is represented by delta X. This is delta theta. Just observe. Average velocity, V or V average, that is velocity by time, delta X by delta T. So X2 minus X1 by T2 minus T1. Generally, the difference between the distance or displacement by difference between time, delta X by delta T. So angular velocity is represented by omega. Our average, this is omega average. So theta 2 minus theta 1 by T2 minus T1, or simply delta theta by delta T. Acceleration, linear acceleration represented by A. Angular acceleration is represented by alpha. So this is average acceleration, V2 minus V1 by T2 minus T1, or delta V by delta T. So here you can observe this is angular acceleration average, alpha average, omega 2 minus omega 1 by T2 minus T1, delta omega by delta T. Already you studied in your intermediate. So linear momentum is represented by P, the product of mass and that velocity. That is linear momentum. The linear momentum is represented by P. Angular momentum L. So angular momentum is represented by capital L. So this is L is equal to I into omega. This is moment of inertia I,
At the place of small m, we can write I. At the place of V, we can write omega. L is equal to I omega. Or R, L bar is equal to R bar cross P bar. This is the position vector. This is the linear momentum. Linear momentum. So in translational motion, this is the force. Force. What is the formula? Force F is equal to ma or dp by dt or a is equal to d square x by dt square. We can write m d square x by dt square. Already we learned in our free oscillations, that is simple oscillator. So this is torque tau is equal to I alpha or L bar is equal to R bar cross F bar. So this is torque tau bar, not L bar. This is torque tau bar is equal to R bar cross F bar. F bar. So translational kinetic energy, in general kinetic energy of mv square, or in terms of momentum p square by 2m. So here kinetic energy half I omega square. At the place of m, we can write I. At the place of v, omega square. So simply p square by 2m formula, that is L square by, this is at the place of p, we can write L square by 2i. L square by 2i. This is rolling motion, a motion that combines linear motion and rotational motion, that is translational motion and rotational motion of an object with respect to a surface. So rolling motion, translational plus rotational. You studied this formula in your intermediate. So this is the rolling motion, half mv square, 1 plus k square by r square. So we can observe here, up to here, if you have any doubt, please ask me. Up to here, if you have any doubt, please ask me. Yes. If you have any doubt. So in linear motion, at the place of S, we can write theta. Right? So I am starting here, linear motion, S at the place of S is equal to, we can write theta. And another one, u, you can see here, u is equal to, we can write omega naught. This is, what is u? Initial velocity. Final velocity, v, we can write in terms of omega. So this is linear motion displacement. This is angular motion displacement. So acceleration, alpha, a, in terms of, we can write alpha. Alpha. At the place of m, we can write I. I. At the place of force, we can write torque, tau. At the place of momentum, we can write L. So it is disturbing. I am removing from this place. Okay. You can observe here. So at the place of P, at the place of P, I am using this pen. So at the place of P, we can write L. L. So in general, I am writing here, number one, V is equal to U plus AT in translational motion. You studied in your intermediate equation of motions. But at the place of V, we can write omega. This is initial velocity omega naught plus alpha t. Alpha t. So second one, S is equal to ut plus half at square. S is equal to ut plus half at square. But this is theta is equal to omega naught t plus half alpha t square. We can write simply. So write down third one, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. 2as. So according to this relation, we can write, what is this? This is omega square minus omega naught square is equal to 2 alpha theta. Similarly, we can write any equation. So fourth equation, S is equal to u plus a into n minus half. Here theta is equal to omega naught plus alpha into n minus half. We can write all the equations. What about displacement? This is s. Here theta. So what about velocity? V is equal to ds by dt. Or if this is x, so we can write this is dx by dt. So here angular velocity. Some person is disturbing. I will mute all of you. D theta by dt. So acceleration a is equal to, we can write rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity. So pen has gone. I am taking here. So this is d square x by dt square. D square x by dt square. So here we can write. Here we can write here. What is this? Alpha is equal to d omega by dt, or this is d square theta by dt square. You can write any formula. What about force? Please write down. Anyone can tell me. F is equal to ma. So m into a, we can write d square x by dt square. We write in equation of motion. So here, what about this? Torque tau is equal to
I alpha.
Because at the place of m, we can write I. At the place of acceleration, we can write alpha. That is equal to I into alpha. We can write d square theta by dt square. Right? What about kinetic energy? Already we discussed kinetic energy. So K, kinetic energy, K dot E is equal to half mv square. Here kinetic energy, what is this? Tell me, half
I omega square.
I omega square. So it is very useful to our torsional pendulum. So we can write at the place of s, that is theta, we can write initial velocity. At the place of initial velocity, we can write this is omega naught. At the place of final velocity, this is angular velocity. Final angular velocity, this is acceleration. In linear motion, this is acceleration in rotational motion. So mass, this is I. Force, this is torque. So momentum, this is L. So we can write these formulas like this. We can write all the formulas. So
dear students, I am closing this session. So thank you all.